Simple Stories flipbooks, fabulous and easily customizable books that can do way more than hold photos. With two sizes and multiple pocket configurations, they're perfect to display many of the types of projects we all create. ATCs, tags, index cards, and a whole lot more slip into the pockets and are ready to be shared with anyone who browses what's inside. In today's video, I'll show you how I use flipbooks, how to alter the covers, and the kinds of little art bits I store in mine. Links to all of the products can be found in the expanded description below. When I saw Simple Stories flipbooks at Creativation, I was fascinated by the possibilities. And while they're wonderful for use with photos and for memory keeping, they're also an incredible way to get your art out of the drawer. With multiple pocket sizes of 3x4, 4x6, and 6x8, you can include your ATCs or ATC-sized bits, 4x6 index cards, and the like. Plus, our number 8 tags will fit in that 4x6 size with just a little tiny bit of trimming to take maybe an eighth of an inch off the length. With the 6x8 size, the sky is pretty much the limit. Larger index cards, bigger tags as you see here, everything else that you can think of. This is a 5x7 index card. This is a 6x8 piece of paper. So I'm going to page through these afterward, but I want to talk about the flipbooks themselves before I do. So they are available in two sizes. They've got 6x8 in a portrait orientation, and then they have 4x6 or 6x4 technically that's in a landscape orientation. So what we have, I chose neutral colors for this first order. So there are actually four styles. Let me get the last one. So what we have are these, what is this called? Speckle dots. Then we have this whitewashed wood, buffalo check, and black. Now we have these across both of the sizes. It just so happens that I used the 6x8 buffalo check and I used the 4x6 whitewashed, although you kind of can't tell because I've changed the covers up a little bit. But with that said, this is what we have at the moment. There are solid colors that eventually I'll probably bring in. So when you receive these inside the 4x6, you're going to receive 10, whoops, let's turn it this way. You're going to receive 10 pages that have 4x6 pockets. When you talk about the 6x8 size, and I need to turn this so that I can read it, you get 10 pockets, but there are going to be 3 that are 6x8, 3 that are 4x6, 2 that are 3x4, and then 2 that are a combination of 3x4 and 4x6. And you'll see all of these as I start to page through this stuff, with this stuff. So along with the refill pages are these cool things they call photo flips. So let me bring them out. And what these are, if you look at these, let's see. See how they show this flipped? That's what this is. When you look at these, and I have one, where do I have one? I have one here because I'm going to put one on the inside back cover of my 6x8. So this is a photo flip. This happens to be a 4x6 photo flip. There's adhesive on here. You remove this and adhere it. Now I'm not going to adhere this one because I have plans for this cover before I go ahead and put the photo flip on. But if I bring this piece out, and this is a masking tape bound book that I created a number of years ago, but you can see that I've already put 4x4 ones in here and they kind of cascade, which I think is cool. So again, you take the liner paper off, and I'm going to turn this way. And I started from the bottom and I'm working my way up. So then I'm going to arrange this one kind of like this. And someplace here I have a piece of paper cut that I'm ready to stick in there. But of course, I had it and I no longer have it. I'll find it in this in the intermission here when I jump to the next segment, and then I'll show it to you. So the other thing that's included here, because again, Simple Stories does these with photographs and memory keeping in mind, they also give you these photo crops. So inside are all of these elements, and all you have to do is line them up on a photo or a piece of paper. You can either trace or just go ahead and align. So this is fairly thick plastic. You can lay this plastic down and kind of imagine what will be in the picture, if you will, because you can see that the crop highlights what's going to be underneath it. And then you lay this down and you cut. So super simple. In the next segment, I'm going to show you how to take the snapbooks apart, how you can add pages or arrange what comes in each in a way that suits your project. And then I'm going to show you the inside of mine and talk about customizing the covers and all of the good stuff that you can display in the pockets. before I show you how to take a flip book apart, add some pages, and then put the whole thing back together, let's come back to that flip page for a second. So this is the one that you saw me just put in, and I have this piece that's 4x4 and is all ready to go, so it just slips in. And I like the idea that this cascades like this. Now, if I had something longer, I obviously could have made a longer cascade, and you can think about that when you're working with the 6x8 because it affords you a lot more room to play around. Okay, so now let's talk about this. This is a 4x6 flip book, and I'm going to take it out of the package. This is the one that happens to be speckled up. All right, so straight out of the package, what you'll get inside, let's slip this off. I could tear this, I just hate to do it, don't ask me why. I'm the person who can't rip wrapping paper either. Makes for a very frustrating Christmas morning. Okay, so when you open this up, this happens to be the front. I can tell because I have this bar of metal right here. And when you flip it over to the back, you can see that this is the mechanism that's going to allow you to rejigger this. It's going to allow you to take it apart and redo it in whatever way that you want. So all you have to do is slide this out of the way. Whoops, wrong way. Slide this out of the way. Go like this, bring this one up. Ultimately, you need these little slides to be under these metal flaps. And once you do that, you can lift the flap off, the cover comes off, and now you have access to all of the pages. Now, in the case of the 4x6, it comes with 10 pockets that are 4x6. So here is the top of the pocket. What I want to do is add some of the 3x4s. So I'm going to open up this package of 3x4s, and I want to be certain that I orient the tops of these where the openings are correctly. And it's not like I can't take it apart, but why would I want to torture myself that way? Okay, so the opening is here. I'm going to take some of these out, and then I'm going to slip in, let's see where the openings are. This is the opening there. I'm going to slip a couple of these on the little metal tabs, and then I'll, again, making certain these are oriented correctly. I'm going to go ahead and put some of these back. And obviously this process is identical for the 6x8. You just get a little bit bigger variety of things to choose from in terms of the layout of the pockets because it's a bigger surface to work with. All right, so we'll put these back on. And then we'll put this last 3x4 on. Then the cover goes back on. Oops, let's do it the correct way. Let me think about what I'm doing here. This goes like this. And then this goes back on like this. And now what you have to do is, let's turn this way. You got to get these tabs out of the way. So you bend this back down, slide the piece back, slide this one out of the way, bend this back down, and then slide it back. And it's as simple as that. And now everything is in place and is as it should be. And if you've done things correctly, all of the openings are on the top. And if it's not that way, it's easy enough to take apart and do it. Now I'm going to show you my flip books and talk a little bit about the stuff that I put inside. You know, initially I said, get your stuff out of the drawers. And this is what happens. I make stuff for videos. You see me create stuff all the time. These are some oversized, these are the supersized ATCs I made when, let me think about this. This is Rebecca Myers when her latest release of Rice Paper was new. This is from Milo Leisure's release. This is stuff that I made probably 3 or 4 years ago. I have a bag full of these. I have drawers full of stuff. When you see me demo, I don't get rid of this. It goes into drawers. And this you might have remembered from the release that was, let me think about this. This was Rebecca Myers, the special we had on some of her stencils. That's what all of this is from. You might recognize some of this. And then there's just, I have drawers full of stuff to pull from. This was ancient. I couldn't even tell you how long ago I did this. But there's all of this stuff. And then I have drawers that are full of journal pages, disc-bound journal pages. You can clip those ends off. Just go ahead and trim them off and use what's left. If they didn't make it to a journal, that's fine too. And then index cards, I save everything. So let's start with the 4x6. This cover was done, if you recognize this, this is the brand new, or almost brand new, 49 in Market Spectrum Gardenia. This is the washi tape. This is one of Marlene's new quirky people from her release. And then inside, more 49 in Market with one of the pockets. Some of this is just paper. I've just stuck it in here. This happens to be a journal page. I didn't trim it off. You can see the disc-bound notches right there. Vicky P. This is a tag I probably made 3 or 4 years ago. You might have remembered this from when I showed you how you can add color using paint and gloss sprays to Dina Wakely's transparencies. But again, all of this stuff, Milo's, again, some of her rice paper faces, all of this stuff gets thrown in drawers until I'm ready to use it, or in a case like this. Now I have a place to display it, which I think is marvelous. I could have done this thematically, but I didn't. I just pick and chose what I wanted to put in here. Something like this doesn't have anything on it, but it has a spot and it's ready to go when there is something on it. 49 and Market. They're papers. These 6x8, this one happens to be Spectrum Gardenia, someplace here, our nature study. These, when we get to the 6x8, these just slide right in the pocket. You don't have to trim or do anything, and it's ready to go with whatever it is that you want to do with it. This happens to be a piece of a 6x8 that I just cut down. This is an older release from Marlene. This is her Out of This World, a tag. Again, if you trim about a 16th of an inch off the end, pew, goes right in that 4x6 slot. Now we're into the more of the 3x4s. So our supersized ATCs are 3x4. They fit right in here. A regular ATC fits in there. It's a little bit smaller, but it still fits in there fine. Again, another number 8 tag. I put some of the postage 49 and Market Spectrum Gardenia on there. More of Marlene's new release stuff, the Quirky People, and some of her quotes. Again, there's all of this stuff. This is probably a year old, but all of this stuff has been languishing in drawers waiting for places to go. And now with these flipbooks, I have places. This, I took, the cover looked like this. This is the 49 and Market, the new vintage artistry nature study. It is a gorgeous collection. This, everything here, paper, rub-ons, some of these laser cuts, and this is one of the, I think it's called an envelope pocket, I don't remember exactly. 5x7 index cards. More 5x7 index cards. This is, you might have remembered this from Elizabeth's Matisse stencil mask release. This is one that I did when I was working on that video with her when we were in Sedona. This is ancient, but I pulled it out. I loved the color. I loved it with one of these quirky people, and again, easy, good to go. This is a piece of 6x8 paper. I haven't done anything to it, but it too is ready to go. There's another piece under here, and I also stuck, I haven't glued this down because I'm not positive this is where it's going to go, but I stuck this is I think a 6x8. That might be, let me see. Nope, I'm wrong. That's a 5x7 index card. Slides right in there, looks great. 4x6 index cards, I showed you. I have all of this stuff that I accumulate. It's in here, it's ready to go, the backgrounds are done. I just have to decide what I want to do. This is a tag. This is a number 12 tag I cut down. I covered it with one of our rice papers about 3 years ago. I pulled it out of the drawer, cut it down, and now it's in here again, ready to go. More Marlene stuff, more nature study, more Matisse. I don't remember what this was from. More of the nature study, and again, some ATCs and supersized ATCs that I made probably 5 or 6 years ago. So here too, as you saw this a moment ago, here too is an inside front cover that I've put a piece of the nature study. This is from one of the 12x12 pieces of paper. I put this on here. I'm going to add some rub-ons and some other things, and then that inside front cover will be done, and then I can start adding the photo flips to it. So I hope that you seeing these pages fills you with ideas and inspiration for your own flipbooks, and let me grab this and show you what I'm going to do with the inside cover. So I have lined this with our sticky stuff. This is a piece of one of the 49 and Market nature study papers. It's left over. Is this? Nope, that's not the one I'm looking for. That's too small. This is the one I'm looking for. So this is a leftover piece, and if I put this on here like this, yep, the text is going in the other direction, but by the time I get through putting stuff on here, it doesn't make a hill of beans worth of difference. So this has already got a piece of our sticky stuff on it. So all I have to do is just burnish the edge down, and then I can remove the liner paper. You can see that this was the weathered wood. I've just gone ahead and covered that up. So I'm going to line this up with the bottom edge aligned with the bottom of this inside cover, and this side edge aligned right along this black that's part of the binding. And then all I have to do is trim out two sides. Well, assuming I do it correctly, I only have to trim out two sides. Ooh, sticky stuff, one and done. Let's see if I can make that. There. Ooh, that just made it. Okay, so now if you give me a second, I'm going to go, you can see the back of this was plaid, I'm going to go trim this all off, and then I'm going to come back in just 1 second, and I'll show you how I put some rub-ons on there and embellish that inside cover. I've trimmed the paper on the inside of this back cover, and I've already put one of the color wash rub-ons here, so let me talk about them for just 1 second before I go ahead and start applying. There are 3 12x12 in the Vintage Artistry Nature Study release, the three that you see here. This is, I think this is named Sentiments, this is Color Wash, and this one doesn't seem to have a name per se. It just says rub-on transfer sheet, but this is the one with the florals and the mushrooms. There are smaller rub-ons too. I want to say there's another 2 or 3 sets, and I may bring some of those in, but first let's go ahead and work with this. So inside each of the packages are these little applicator tools, and yes, you can use this, but I find it's far more effective. I get more done if I use the back end, and I'm going to try applying it to this inside this piece here that's black. That's, I think it's fabric, or it's some kind of a synthetic that's made to look like fabric, and I don't know if it'll stay, but it's worth a shot because it kind of brings the design into that edge besides just being on the paper itself. So this is going to be a little bit of a challenge, only because probably the best thing to do is going to be to trim this off before I try to remove this. And I'll save this. I'll do something with that because it's just some splotches and they'll kind of go anywhere. It really doesn't make any difference. And while I'm here, well, you know what, on the top it doesn't really make any difference because most of that is just the paper or the plastic that the rub-on is on. So I'm going to see if I can start pulling this off. Here we go. Occasionally you miss a piece, you just come back and you press it some more. But this stuff is pretty quick. And, you know, 10 years ago, 5 years ago, rub-ons kind of felt like they were kids' crafts, but not anymore. Boy, the stuff that is being produced now is amazing. And most amazing among them are these wonderful rub-ons in all the collections from 49 and Market. Okay, so I've got my splotches, and they've carried over to that inside piece that is the cover. I have, if I could get it apart, so these are sticky. You want to put these face up so that nothing, they don't stick to your surface. I've got this one, this is from the collection I said that doesn't really have a name. I've got this piece here that I'm going to put about like this. I just want to make certain that it's straight because there's this grid in the background. I'd like for it to not look wonky. Same kind of thing. I'm just going to go ahead and apply pressure with the back of this tool and then just peel the released acrylic or acetate off. Let's see what this looks like. Oops, missed it just a little bit here and there. All right, that is marvelous. And then I'm going to take this from the sentiment sheet, and I'm going to put the word observe. Let's see. I don't think I want to center it. That's a little too samey-samey for me. So I think what I'm going to do is just start it down on this edge like this. Go ahead and apply it. Okay. So I have this leftover bit that I trimmed. So what I'm going to do is just apply it to the cut edge up here at the top. And you can put rub-ons over rub-ons, which makes this really cool. So I'm just going to go ahead and rather than toss it, I'm going to just put it along the top here. And it just adds a little bit of doodads there. That's all that I'm looking for, is just some extra doodads. Now, if I'm done with this, then it's great. It really looks good like this. But if I decide I want to take it a little bit further, here is one of the sets that is the 6x8. I could take some elements from this. There's at least one more, and as I said, possibly two. Or I could grab some of these wonderful butterflies. I could take, these are all laser cut, so they pop out. Or I have the mushrooms and the foliage elements. So I could start poking around with this. I'm not going to make you watch me do this because that's just kind of silly. But when you look at these, you open these up, these become full 12 by 12 sheets. And as you can see, they are in fact all laser cut, so they pop right up. I don't know that there's, and you know what, this is something that 49 & Market does that I really like. On the back of the front cover that shows you everything that's in here, there are all these bits that you can fussy cut and use. So this doesn't go in recycling, it actually mostly gets used. For this I would probably, I might grab a mushroom and maybe add it to this. Let's see what's in here that we could use. Just something small. What about this? Now I probably wouldn't put just this one piece on. I might add a little bit more. So that could go there, and then maybe, what else do we have? Oh, I think this is supposed to be a morel. So let's grab that, and then maybe, nope, I don't like the way that that looks. But I think I might just put this on, and then I think there's room up here for a butterfly. So, as I said, anything that you've got sitting in drawers that's partly done are going to be wonderful to put in these pocket pages, whether it's 3x4, it's 4x6, or we start looking at all of the bigger combinations that are part of that 6x8 journal, which is here. I think that this is a wonderful, oops, is this upside down? No, it's, yes it is. I think that this is a wonderful idea. It means that the stuff that's been languishing in my drawers has a chance to come out, and now it's in a place where I can pick this up and look at it at any time. If I want to, I can swap things in and out. Spectrum Gardenia, 49 & Market, Nature Study, pretty much anything you can think of. Actually, even fun things like this. So this is the Retro Summer Craft Consortium 6x6 paper pad. All you have to do is cut 2 inches off, and now you have a 4x6-inch piece that's colored on both the front and the back, and it's ready to slip in this 4x6 slot. There's a bajillion other things that you can use here. Take that stuff that you've been accumulating, pull it out. Whether it's paper like this, or it's embellishments, or it's stuff that you've already started, and start filling these pages.